All right, Shalom. First off and foremost, I want to give him my honors, praise, and glories to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Double honors to my apostles and elders of GMS that do well, starting off with the apostles, hard on down, the true men of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, that's laboring the truth for 30 plus years, still pushing and still enduring to this day. All right, and the sincere Shalom to Akim out there, that's pushing the truth through spirit, through the power, and through the name of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai. To seal the elect Israel, followed by the 1/3 of Israel, okay? Now, real quick, you know, basically, I just want to go into about how all these people out here, the ones that's, don't believe in the higher power, the ones that scoff, the people that are contrary to Yahweh Shemal Shah, all right? You people are anti-Mashiach, or, in other words, anti-Christ, all right? You people are, disobedient, right? People are brute beasts, okay? People are rude, selfish, and considerate Americans, man, all right? This place has no order. America is the land of confusion, okay? And why is America like this? Because it is ran by the son of perdition, the son of destruction, the damn devil, Esau, the so-called white man. All right, it's ran by your Edomite elites. All right, that's why America is the way it is. That's why the whole earth is the way it is. Okay, because it's ran by the devil, man, the deceiver Esau, man. All right, and being that this devil rules the earth right now, this appointed time. All right, people that are under his vibration. All right, are fine with the ways things are fine with the ways. The way that things are right now, all right, you are fine with things being upside down, being backwards, man. Okay, and that's why people out here are anti Mashiach, all right, or for speaking on natural man's level, anti Christ. Okay, but without further ado, I'm making some scriptures and I'm willing to be edifying to you, Akim out there. All right, this is Saint Job 9:24, and it says, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covered the face of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? Right, man. And it says the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. All right. Meaning that Yahweh Shema Shai gave this damn devil Esau the whole earth for a certain amount of time. Right before he's thrown down. Okay. Because Esau is not going to continue to rule forever. All right. No, no, no. All right, according to the Holy Bible, all right, America, all right, and Esau, all right, he's bound to be brought down low and to never rise again into power, okay. And being that the whole earth has been given to the hand of the wicked Esau, all right, the whole earth is out of whack, okay. The whole earth is filled with nothing but anti-Mashiach, besides the elect, okay, besides those men. Right, but besides those men, the whole earth is completely in darkness, man. Completely effed up. All right, this is a discombobulated dystopia, man. All right, this is a complete dystopia. All right, Esau he produces nothing but satanic things unto people, man. Demonic things onto people, and people eat it all up, man. He pushes that homosexuality agenda. Okay, especially on the Israelites. All right, he pushes fools that are deemed abominable in the Bible. He pushes those fools to be a delicacy. All right, in his society. All right, things of that nature. All right, those are the things that's going on here in Esau's rulership, man. Because the earth was given into his hand. All right, you have pedophilia going on. You have fake foods being produced unto the people. All right, GMO foods. Okay, you have people, especially Jake, being put under the jail for a long ass time, all right, serving a triple lifetimes, all right, things like that is wicked, man, all right. People uphold these things. People They are okay with these things. Okay, and that's why you people are anti-Christ, man. All right, you people are contrary to Yahweh Shema Shai in the Bible, man. People are contrary to the ancient ways. Okay, but soon, ancient ways, all right, meaning, you know, the laws of the Bible are going to be, put in complete effect. Okay, because nobody is, you know, actually following the laws of Yahweh Shema Shai. They're following the laws of Esau, man. Because why? Because the earth was given to him. And that's why, you know, this is Esau's heaven. You know, he runs it. All right. And then real quick, I want to get Sirach chapter 10 and verse 2. Come on. Sirach 10 and verse 2. And it says, as the judge of the people is himself, all right, so are his officers, and what manner of man the ruler of the city is, such are all they that dwell therein. Right, so being that Esau is a wicked being, and being that he's the son of perdition, he doesn't believe in a higher power, all right, that's the ways of the people as well, man, okay, because what Esau pushes on the masses and on the sheeple, okay, you people eat it up, all right? You people believed what Esau believes in, man. Okay, you people believe in, you know, a gay marriage. People believe in, you know, adultery. You people believe in, you know, destroying your body, all right? Your temple and smoking, all right? You people believe in all these wicked things, all right? Because why? Because Esau. Man. All right, Esau is the king. Esau is the king right now, man. You know, on this side. All right. You know, and he's the king of Babylon right now, man. All right, the whole world right now, man. Okay, Esau's wine. All right, and the wine is symbolic for, you know, his doctrines and shit like that, his ways of life. All right, this wine has spread across the four winds of the earth, man. All right, people believe anything that this damn devil say. All right, Esau can make a law right now to, you know, for people to walk naked in the streets, and they will do it, man. All right, these people are so far gone. People are oblivious, man, and that's that gross darkness. All right, then that's mentioned in Isaiah the 60th chapter, man. All right, I believe verse 2, man. All right, it says in 1 John 5:18. This whole world lied to wickedness. That's that darkness, man. That this completely out of whack society, man. Okay, so the people, you know, being that Esau's ruling, they are under his vibration. All right, they're gone, man. Especially the Israelites, especially the 2/3 of our people. They are far gone, man. They ain't with their oppressor. All right, they want to live eating my lifestyle, all right? But nah, man, this is not your kingdom yet, man. This is not your heaven to be trying to fulfill and eating my lifestyle, man. You are still under curses. It says that these curses shall overtake you, man, and follow you, man. All right, roughly paraphrasing, okay? Especially Jake, man. Jake trying to be something he not, man. All right, Jake wanna stay here in Babylon, man. Just like the ancient time during Moses, all right. You know, Jake told Moses that they said they'd rather serve Pharaoh than being in the wilderness, man. All right, roughly paraphrasing that, okay. But you know, that's point right there, man. You know, Esau, he's a damn devil, man. And anything he push out to the masses, push out to the people, they take it just like that, man. All right, Esau, he can. He can, you know, well, actually, it is legal. You have a satanic church, all right? And everybody these days, they worship Satan, man, you know? Except for the elect. These people out here worship Satan openly, man. You got a fucking, the Baphomet statue out there in Little Rock, Arkansas, man. All right? This place has to go, man. All right? That's a lot from my rant, all right? Just the spirit right now, man. All right? America is a place of America is a cold, cruel place, man. All right, and this is the hell of the Israelites, man. All right, the earth is given to him, the wicked, man. And people out here are just nothing but a little Edomites running around, man. If you follow, they follow the ways of Esau, man. All right, a damn nothing but anti-Mashiachs, man. All right, Antichrist, man. Okay. This is the book of First John 2:18. Okay. And it says, a little children, it is the last time. And as you have heard, the Antichrist, right, or Anti-Mashiach shall come. Even now are there many Anti-Mashiachs. Whereby we know that it is the last time. Right, man. There are many Anti-Mashiachs, man. All right. There's not one Antichrist. All right. There's not one Antichrist. All right. If you you're considered an Antichrist or Anti-Mashiach, if you're not down with the program of Yahweh Bashem HaShai, okay. If you're not down with the ways and the doctrine of the Heavenly Father, man, you are considered an Anti-Mashiach, man. Okay, because rather you serving the Heavenly Father and you doing the things that are according to the Bible, all right. You people out here, you would rather serve your own self and your flesh, all right. And while we're doing that. You still serve Esau, man. All right. And people serve Esau every day, man. People serve Esau every day. All right. Off the rip, just doing it off the strength. All right. People don't care, man, that you're a slave, man. All right. People are slaves out here, man. All right. Everybody out here is anti-Mashiach, serving Esau with no damn problem. All right. And I believe, let me go back to the other app. All right. If you go into the word Christ of Antichrist, all right. Let me see. 1 John 2:18. All right. And this proves that right here, people are anti-Messiahs. It says the adversary of the Messiah. All right. I'm gonna read it one more time. It says. The adversary of the Messiah. Now, real quick, let's go into the word adversary. All right, let's see what it means. All right. The word adversary on the online etymology. All right, it says unfriendly opponent, enemy. Originally, especially of Satan as the enemy of mankind. Right, because the word Satan means adversary. And it says hostile opponent, enemy. All right, rival, okay, contrary, opposite, hostile. All right, you get the point. All right, so people out here, people are adversaries towards Yahweh Bashem HaShai, man. All right, you people out here despise the light, man. All right, you despise the prophets. All right, you despise, you despise reproof. Okay, and actually, real quick, I'll actually get that. Okay, because people out here, when they see the prophets of Yahweh Bashem HaShai, they disregard them. All right, especially our people. All right, and once they see them, they say things that's bullshit, things of that nature. All right, but. That means that they despise the light. They despise his word, this truth. All right. This word is condemning them. All right. And they love light. I'm going to just get it. All right. He's going to say it anyway. This John 3:18, it says, or excuse me, 19, it says, and this is the condemnation, the light's come into the world. All right. It says, and men love darkness rather than light. Because their deeds were evil, right, man? So people love darkness rather than light, meaning that people love people love sinning, basically, man. People love being an anti-Christ, all right? People love following the ways of Esau, man, okay? And that's going to be your ultimate demise, okay? Because Esau is going to get thrown down anyway, all right, in America, all right? And people are going to go right along with it. All right, in that lake of fire, man. All right, but before that, people are going to get are gonna get shot down the streets by FEMA troops. People are gonna get are gonna get plagues upon you. All right, things are gonna happen. All right, on a tremendous level, man. All right, unto you people out here, man. The ones that despise the ways of Yahweh Shema Shad, man, the light. Okay, and it says because their deeds were evil, right, man. So because their deeds were evil, and they want to continue to walk in that darkness, you know, that, you know, they want to continue to walk in that, you know, to be a damn demon, basically, man. All right, you know, these people, especially here in America, they love the flesh, man. You know, they can't depart from the flesh. All right, they can't walk in the spirit. You know, they can't control themselves, man. You know, they can't rule the spirit. All right, you know, and being in the flesh, you know, and nothing good comes from the flesh, man. All right, only thing that comes in the flesh is what? Evil deeds, man. All right, and that's what they love, man. You know, they love darkness rather than light. Because what? Because their deeds were evil. All right, and it says, verse 20, for everyone that doeth evil will hate the light. And it's right, man. So the prophets out there, you know, the Yahweh Shema Shai's men are constantly out there in the highways and byways and, you know, YouTube and stuff like that, constantly, you know, getting on you people, man, and, you know, and rebuking you, man. All right. But people, you know, they don't want to be changed. You know, they don't want to be converted, you know, and reproved and rebuked, you know, so they scoff, they scorn. All right. Because they hate the light and love evil. All right. And it says, neither come to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. Right, man. That's the point right there, man. All right. And people are damn adversaries to Yahweh Shema Shai, man. All right. It doesn't say he that despised you despised me, and he that despised me despised the one that sent me. All right. So people are damn near. You are contrary. It's like you're not. You're not damn near. You are contrary to Yahweh Shema Shai, man. Okay. You are the opposite of the Yahweh Shema Shai. All right. And like I said, going back to Job 9:24. All right. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. All right. Being that the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. All right. Everything is upside down, man. All right. People uphold the way of life being ruled in an unrighteous manner. All right. They uphold the ways of in America being upside down. They love it. All right. Going back to John 3:19. You know, they love the darkness. You know, they hate the light. All right. Isaiah 5:20. It says, "Woe to them that call evil good and good evil." Right. The word woe means what? Destruction. You know, it says, "Woe to them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and life for darkness." All right. That put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter, man. All right. And that's mainly what people do out here, man. They put things that are evil, wicked, and satanic. They put, they, you know, they deem that to be good, man. You know, they deem that to be on a right-handed, on the right-handed side, man. But nah, man. That's ways of Esau, man. Esau pushes things like that. Esau pushes, you know, a satanic vibrations unto you people, man. All right, and the things that are righteous, you know, that are actually good, people hate it, man. All right, a prime example is the men speaking truth out there, man. The men of Yahweh Shema Shai speaking truth out there into the ears of the people, man. People scoff at that constantly, man. And that's why Yahweh Shema Shai is gonna destroy America, man, because this place is filled with nothing but demons, man. This America is a city of demons, man. All right, this is Sodom and Gomorrah 2.0, Egypt all over again, man. And it's going to be a beautiful sight in our eyes, Lord willing. You know, Lord willing, you know, speaking as man, I'm part of the elect. All right, it's going to be a beautiful sight in our eyes to see America fall, man. To see America be rewarded, man. You know, to see America be thrown down once and for all, man. All right, right along with the people in it, man. Okay. And with that being said, I want to say call Allah Yahweh Shema Shai, Bahashem, Mukakwadash forever. All right, until next lesson, I say Shalom.